news and notes.
Alrighty, so like we had just said, our news and notes segment from here going forward is now sponsored by Shortboxed, the easiest and safest way to buy and sell graded comics. You can download the Shortboxed app on iOS and Android, and please use our code OBP15 at checkout for $15 off your first order. That is OBP at checkout. And thank you so much, Shortboxed, for sponsoring the show. Off the top here, we have a brand new Pokémon Scarlet and Violet trailer reveals new legendaries and a release date. So the Pokémon company and developer Game Freak gave Pokémon fans a new look at the next games in the franchise, Pokémon Scarlet and Pokémon Violet, in a new trailer on Wednesday that showed off new Pokémon, a new open world region, and a 2022 release date. So the two new legendary Pokémon are called, and Aaron and I were kind of debating on how you actually say these Pokémon's names before we started recording today. Koryadon? Is that how we decided?
No. So I believe, and I don't want to like hijack your news segment.
No.
I believe it's called Koryadon.
Koryadon.
And for the Scarlet exclusive, and Muraidon for the Violet exclusive, because there's going to be like a new feature of riding on Pokemon in like new different ways, mm-hmm. much like we saw in Arceus.
Yeah.
So I believe that it's pronounced Koryadon and Muraidon. Because of that reason. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. And both of these new legendaries have a type of serpentine design, with Koryadon sporting a red color scheme and then Muraidon primarily purple and kind of like white and gray. So Aaron, off the top, which one are you more leaning towards? Which one do you want more? You know,
absolutely going towards Koryadon.
Yeah, me too. I was kind of hoping that you would take Scarlet because I really want Violet. Purple is my favorite color, and you know, it's a color of royalty. So I want to definitely get Violet. And I was hoping you would take Scarlet, but I'll tell you what, we'll just both get Violet and we'll call it that. So
no. Did I say Violet?
Yes.
I said Scarlet.
Yeah. So I'm sorry. You want a Koryadon.
That's what I said.
Okay, I'm sorry. I misheard you. I apologize.
Are you listening to me? Are you fucking listening
Maybe
to me?
Maybe I just assumed that you were going to pick the same thing as me because we're so like-minded.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah, I want Koryadon because he kind of, again, I believe with this new mechanic of like riding on the Pokemon in different ways, we're going to see more rideable Pokemon. Mm-hmm. And I believe that Koryadon and like, okay, so because with that wheel that comes out of his like neck chest area, I think he's going to be almost like a motorcycle-esque looking one. So that's what draws me towards it. And also like Muraidon just looks like a giant dick and balls.
I'm a big fan of Muraidon. Sorry, I keep trying to say it the way I was saying it before. Muraidon. I think, Aaron, I think you're correct there. I'm going to pick Muraidon. I'm a big fan of that phallic look, so I'm definitely going to pick that for sure. So
Who doesn't love to ride a giant purple dick around the map, right?
So the trailer also showed some non-legendary Pokemon you can expect to find in the new region. So we've got Palmai, which is a electric mouse Pokemon. So another electric mouse Pokemon for the many that have already been introduced in the Pokemon world.
Shocker.
Right. We have Lechonk, which is the normal hog Pokemon. I think people are definitely people are like attaching to Lechonk. That's like the new favorite for the Pokemon community.
Yeah.
And then we have Smoliv, which is a grass normal olive type Pokemon. So do you have a favorite of those three, Aaron? Are there any of those that really jumped out at you?
No, but my immediate reaction on, and I took to Twitter about this, was if Lechonk does not evolve into Lechungus, I'm going to riot.
All right. Yeah, I think Lechonk is like the favorite. I especially of these three, I'm a big fan of Lechonk as well. So the trailer actually introduces two new professors as well. Professor Sada, which is for Scarlet, and Professor Turo for Violet. And they're super sexy. They're so sexy.
They are. Another reason I'm picking Scarlet.
That's right. And these will also
Professor
be the first.
Professor Sada is hot. Sada? Professor
Sada? Is it Sada or Sada?
I love how. I mean, it's Sada me, but you know.
it's, Sada, excuse it's me.
Sada, please. No, it's like if the internet has done the normal Pokemon thing and looted them both already because they are the ultra sexy. And I'm not going to lie. You know what? I'm going to throw this out there, Chris.
Yeah.
Turo, he kind of reminds me of you.
Oh, well, thank you.
I think if you cosplayed any like upcoming character from anything, you like, have you seen him?
Yes, of course. He's a little bit more gray, I think, than I am, but I'm definitely going to like, here in a couple years, I could definitely do the cosplay.
Yeah. You have the same like hair and head mm-hmm. and like body type. Yeah. Dude, I think you should cosplay as him. You know how much attention you get at a convention?
Will you cosplay as Professor Seda with me? Like, will you go as Seda and I'll go as Turo?
I'll go as LeChonk.
Okay, there we go. Like that.
Train me.
This will also be the first Pokemon game to introduce multiplayer. In fact, players will be able to experience these games with up to four other pals. This also means that you'll be able to trade and battle Pokemon, as well as explore various locations in the region with your friends. That's really cool. And we saw a similar thing in Arceus, minus like actually be able to explore with your friends, but they have the online compatibility, which I think most Pokemon games do. But I do like that you can kind of just come into the same world as a Pokemon, one of your Pokemon friends, and play along with them. So Pokemon Scarlet and Pokemon Violet will release on November 12th, 2022. So we don't have to wait that long, only a couple months until this brand new installment here in Pokemon. And I think I can speak for Aaron here when I say that we're both super excited for this new region, this new era of Pokemon.
Yeah, I just went down a rabbit hole for Professor Seda.
Oh, no.
So moving into our next piece of news and notes.
Oh, boy.
Oh, God. The new trailer or the trailer for DC's Gotham Knights series coming to the CW has dropped.
Mm.
The CW released the trailer for the upcoming new live action DC series Gotham Knights. And, well, it's very CW-esque. In Gotham Knights, it's in the wake of Bruce Wayne's murder. So and his body is discovered with the, you know, Batman mask on. So, like, mm-hmm. everybody's like, oh, did you know your dad was Batman? His rebellious adopted son forges an unlikely alliance with the children of Batman's enemies. Oh, my God.
I know.
Didn't the Disney Channel already do this?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Children of Batman's enemy, when they are all framed for killing the Caped Crusader as the city's most wanted criminals, this renegade band of misfits must fight to clear their names, but in Gotham, with no Dark Knight to protect it, the city descends into the most dangerous it's ever been. How many times can it do this?
Right.
Okay. However, hope comes from the most unexpected places. A team of mismatched fugitives becomes its next generation of saviors. The series stars Oscar Morgan as Turner Hayes. And do we need to keep going on? Because I don't give
someone
a crap.
Is
going to
be excited about this, Aaron.
Sorry.
We obviously are not on for this. We're not excited about this series whatsoever. But just for the sake of being
bipartisan as far as
Marvel and DC, yes. You know, we do a lot of Marvel here. We do a lot of DC.
Yeah.
Got to give it its due and then give our opinion at the end, which is going to be terrible.
I'm so glad that you are here to bring me back to the light. I apologize to the listeners, anybody that is really excited for the show. I apologize. Okay, the series stars Oscar Morgan as Turner Hayes,
look at that
Anna
inflection
Moore
change.
As Stephanie Brown, Olivia Rose Keegan as Duella Dent. Really?
that didn't last very long.
Navia Robinson as Carrie Kelly, Fallon Smythe as Harper Rowe, Tyler Dichiara as Cullen Rowe, and Misha Collins as Harvey Dent. Gotham Knights will debut sometime in 2023 season on the CW network. Yay!
Alrighty, so Aaron, what are your thoughts on this trailer?
It looks so terrible.
It looks really bad.
So terrible. Duella Dent.
Duella Dent. Oh man, it should have been Duella and then Cruella. You know, both sides, both faces of Harvey. You know, real subtle names
Duella
for his children.
DeVille. Duella DeVille.
Yeah, this doesn't look good. This does not look good whatsoever. I mean, CW, Aaron and I are notorious for not being huge fans of any of the CW stuff. The Flash, Legends of Tomorrow, Arrow, Supergirl, name it. We don't like it because it's 25 episodes of over drama with a little bit of superheroism, a lot of filler, and I don't think it's for us. You know, if it's a good entryway for some people to get into superheroes, very cool. I respect it for that.
So one of these characters is supposed to be the daughter of the Joker?
Yes. I think it's Stephanie Brown is supposed to be the daughter of the Joker in this series, which is interesting because Stephanie Brown in the comics very much is not that. I could be wrong there. We've only seen the trailer one time, Aaron and I. So and they don't really come out and say in the trailer, but if I'm not mistaken, Anna Lore, she's supposed to be playing Stephanie Brown.
And then Oscar Morgan, he just looks like a dollar store Skarsgård.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And then Misha Collins, but I think, which is kind of like their big draw for this series. He obviously of Supernatural fame playing Harvey Dent. Mm. You don't put Harvey Dent in a series without him eventually becoming Two-Face. So we'll probably see that. I'm going to guess if this does get a second season, that will be the draw for the second season of Gotham Knights here. So Aaron and I's anticipation for this is little to none. Probably won't watch it, I'm guessing, for both of us. Mm-mm. Yeah. All right. Mm-mm. Well, moving on. Moving on to our last bit of news here. We've got James Earl Jones of Obi-Wan Kenobi. James Earl Jones provided the voice for Darth Vader. And I'm sorry, he has provided the voice for Darth Vader since his big debut in 1977 during Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope. We all knew that. He has been providing the voice for Vader ever since, while James Earl Jones is providing the voice for Vader in the series. Hayden Christensen is the actor physically in the suit. According to the official Star Wars Twitter account, the new series is now the most watched Disney Plus original series to premiere to date, based on the hours streamed in opening weekend. This means the series beat out Marvel's The Falcon and Winter Soldier, which previously broke the record last year. Aaron, temperature check on Obi-Wan Kenobi. What are your thoughts on the series thus far? We're going to talk about it much more in depth because we're going to review it on the show, but I just kind of want to get your feeling up to episode 3, because I don't think you had mentioned that you had not seen episode 3 yet. So episode 1 and 2, what are your thoughts thus far?
The shortest answer is that temperature check would be lukewarm.
Nailed it. Great pun there, Aaron. Good job. We haven't seen Luke
Where's
yet.
Where's my sound effect?
Can we say Leia warm for that yeah. last one?
Where's my sound effect?
Oh, hold on. Give me 1 second here. Nailed
Thank
it.
Thank you.
All righty. But yeah, so similar. Very meh. I'm honestly not a huge fan. And I hate it. I really, really hate the fact that these last couple Disney Plus series have been very just, I don't know. It's just not hit me the same way. And that could be, are we getting, you know, too much exposure in these two worlds, in Star Wars and Marvel, to where we're starting to feel a little less excited to be back in those worlds? Or is the quality waning a little bit?
I think it's just, you know, what some of these franchise owners tend to do, you know, when they spread it a little too thin, or they try and wring the rag just a little too tight and it becomes a little bit diluted. Mm-hmm. I think that we're starting to see that potentially but you know, think about it now, also the time between these shows is very much shrinking. We used to have to wait years for a new movie or years for a new show, and they're just pumping out so much content these days that we're not getting any kind of a breather in between. So right. We've come to start, at least in my opinion, I've come to start expecting a certain timeline, a certain almost cadence, a rhythm to some of these movies coming out. And it's just kind of like, it's almost overwhelming now with the amount of content. So I'm not saying that I'm tired of it or it's overwhelming. I just think that if you keep pushing out too much of it, it's going to start to dilute itself. And this might be like what we're seeing. But again, maybe they're just playing with us, because there might be somebody who loves it, might be somebody who hates it, and they're just waiting for the last couple episodes, like they've been doing with some of these shows, to mm-hmm. really make it great.
No, that's absolutely been the case here recently, of course, with especially like Moon Knight. We've said it with Falcon and Winter Soldier, WandaVision, elements of Loki, which is still, again, my favorite Disney Plus Marvel series. I think everything outside of The Mandalorian, and I guess I would include WandaVision and Loki in that. Everything else, though, has had the same formula of the first four episodes are a lot of setup, a lot of slow burn, and then the last two episodes turn mm-hmm. it up, as you had said earlier, up to 11, and just like give us everything we've been wanting for the last four episodes. And that's just, I don't love that format. You know, it feels like a lot of time wasted. I don't know. I feel myself getting a tad tired, and I don't like that, because I love these properties, Star Wars, Marvel, the MCU, everything about both of these franchises I love. And it feels like they just need to take a little bit of a break check, just a little taparoo of that break. Stop pumping them out so quickly. You know, we're getting Ms. Marvel next month. Excuse me, not even next month. We're getting it, I think, in a couple days. It's June 4th while recording this. I think it comes out on the 9th. And then we're getting Thor, Love, and Thunder at the beginning of July. Then we're getting She-Hulk at the end of July. And then we're getting Black Panther, Wakanda Forever in November. And then, like, are you seeing a trend here? Like, there's a lot. There's a lot mm-hmm. happening here. I think Andor is coming out in August. Like, come on. We just need a little bit of a break. It's so much content. And I feel stupid for complaining about this, because if you had asked a nerd in the 80s or even the 90s and said, hey, they're making a show about The Mandalorian, they're making a show about Boba Fett, they're making a show about She-Hulk, like, your mind would go, like explode out of your the side of your ear. But we just we've gotten so much of it, and I need a little bit of a break, you know. And COVID might have had something to do with this as well. COVID stopped put a halt to everything in Hollywood for 2 years, and it feels like maybe they're just trying to catch up a little bit. I hope that's the case, and then eventually we'll start to get a new quality in these shows. But I guess we'll just have to see. So, well, Aaron, that'll do it for our news and notes. We're going to get into our review of Top Gun Maverick. Cannot wait to talk about this. I'm just going to say it right now, this amazing movie. But before we get over there to that review, we're going to take a quick break and we will be right back.